cactus lady. Hey, cacti guy. If you love cactus as much as I do, well, we make a prickly pear. So let's sew one that you can snuggle with. I love a really good sewing slash craft project because it's just so much fun, it comes together quickly, and you think to yourself, do I really need a cactus pillow? I mean, probably, sure, why not? They're just adorable. Cute on a bed, a chair. You can make them with the spines, you can make them plain, you can make them with a lot of spines, or you can just leave them off, and you know, you can always add a little flower. So here's what you need. 2/3 of a yard of fabric, stuffing, yarn, and a hand sewing needle. You can make your cactus from a variety of fabrics, and it's really fun to use quilting cotton, which has a unique print, because you can just leave it as is, and it looks adorable. What I'm gonna use today is some flannel. I found all these at my local fabric shop, and I love this one. It's like the perfect green cactus color. So that's what I'm going to use. You need a front and a back to your cactus, and you can draw your own pattern piece for your own style of cactus. I've created one for you that you can get on my website, go to madeeveryday.com, or you can find a link in the video description. And I've traced that pattern onto cardstock just because it makes it easier for me to trace onto my fabric. If you're drawing your own cactus pattern, just remember that you want to add some seam allowance around the outsides for your pillow. Okay, you could just cut with a rotary cutter, you could use scissors. I'm gonna first trace. I'm just holding my hand down there, and I'm just using a normal pen. You can use a fabric pen, it doesn't really matter. Trace around that guy. Okay. Use your scissors and cut it out. I'm cutting through two layers at once. And if you have a fabric that has a definite right and wrong side, mine doesn't really because it's green on both sides, but it's nice to cut with your two right sides facing each other so that the wrong side is up here. That just means you're totally ready to sew. Right there, you don't have to flip them the opposite direction. Just a little trick that saves some time. Okay, there we go. Set that aside, set this aside, and we'll move these two. Okay, now we're gonna grab our iron, which I have right here. Let's press our fabric, make sure there's no wrinkles, and then we're also gonna do a little time-saving trick. So, we've got both layers here. Press that all out. Now I'm gonna use a 1/4 inch seam allowance on my cactus. And what I like to do is, well, you have to leave an opening, obviously, so you can get the stuffing inside, and so you can, you know, get your hand in and out, turn it right side out. And I like to leave my opening right here on the side. And to make it easier to sew that closed at the very end, I like to press the sides in a little bit. So, or actually, I guess it would be under, over. Here we go. I'm just gonna press this side right like that. And let's do the same on the other side. I'll just flip it here. And that might be a little more than a 1/4 inch, but it will just help later on, you will see. When it's so full of stuffing, it can be hard to tuck those little sides under. Okay, we are ready to go to our sewing machine. Okay, I have my front and my back of my cactus here with right sides together. And we've got our little opening right here, which I'm gonna actually pin to make sure that I don't sew over it. You wanna make it just as big as a fist that you can get in and out with the stuffing. Okay, that's pretty good. Then we're gonna start at one spot, sew around and stop at the other spot. Okay, and if you maybe didn't notice, I'm sewing with a really fun, different machine. It's called Joy, and it's part of the Genuine series by Baby Lock, and it's a great beginner sewing machine. It's also a great machine if you're traveling, because I love how lightweight it is. It's just a cute little machine. It's more simple, but it still has great quality. So, okay, come over here, and I'm gonna use a 1/4 inch seam allowance here. Take that out. Sew a few stitches, then we're gonna do a little back stitch, which on my machine, I have to hold this lever down. Go back stitch, okay, and then sew around. As you go around these curves, you might wanna go a little bit slowly, or what you can do is leave your needle down, lift your presser foot, pivot a little bit, just allows the fabric to relax a little bit as you're going around the curves. When you get to the corner, just lift your presser foot, pivot, and turn. Okay, keep going around. And you know, I probably should have pinned around to make sure all my layers are staying together. But with flannel, they kind of stick to each other, right? Okay, I'm gonna do a little pivot turn here. I'm just working slowly. Okay, I'm to my stopping point. I'm gonna take that pin out, do my little backstitch. Okay, then I make sure my needle is up on this machine. I just pull it this way and I can cut my threads right here. Boop. Oh, I missed one. Or I can use my scissors. Okay, now before we turn it right side out, let's trim down our seam allowance a little bit. This will just help all those curves lay really nicely. I'm cutting down to about 1/8 of an inch. Just make sure you do not cut into the stitch line. And you know, so it's just different preferences. Some people like to clip around the curves. I think that trimming just takes out some of the bulk and I don't know, I just feel like it lays a little better, especially if you're working with a garment, a shirt, something like that. Okay, I've gone all the way around. I'm not going to trim this opening area. We're gonna leave that just as it is so it can turn under easily. Okay, get rid of all that. Now let's turn this thing right side out and see what it looks like. This is always a fun part of any project. And it's so fun to make little pillows of any shape. Again, you don't always need those things, but it sure makes life happy and fun. Okay, oops, I missed one of the arms. Did you know that saguaro cactus, the specific type of cactus we're sewing here, only grows in the Sonoran Desert? So it's not everywhere in the world, which is pretty special and unique. So now you can have it anywhere in the world in your house. Okay, let's look at this. Okay, awesome. Looking pretty good. Now see these little corners right here? If that's kind of looking a little bunched up, you can actually, like I was saying, trim or cut, clip into those a little bit more to help them lay more flat. But as we start getting the stuffing in, it will help that spread out a little more. Okay, grab our stuffing. I've got my giant bag right here. And I found that one of these bags usually makes about 2 cactus pillows. So keep that in mind. Then just start grabbing and start a stuffing. This is actually a really, this whole project is kind of a little therapeutic. It's one of those ones you can do in front of the TV. You can do late at night. You can take it with you. Oh my goodness. I love projects like that. In fact, at my daughter's piano lesson, I was sewing the little spines on. So it's a fun thing to do. Okay, push it all the way to the ends. And again, personal preference, how stuffed you want your cactus to be. I think it's better when you stuff it pretty full. So you're just gonna keep going. And when you think that you just can't fit more, you just try again and usually you can fit a little bit more. And your stuffing bags, let's see if I can find it in here. Oh yes. Sometimes they do put a little stick in here. There you go. That you can help. You know, if you had something really tight, you could really jam it in there. This isn't too tight. You can pretty much just use your finger to help push it down. So, okay, well, I'm gonna be here for a little while. So, you know, just keep stuffing. Okay, this is pretty stuffed. You can see it's starting to spill out a little bit. And don't worry if it's a little bit lumpy, and you can kind of work through that, you know, push it around a little bit or stuff more into make those lumps sit a little better. Also, if you're gonna sew yarn on it, you might not even see that as much. Okay, what I'm gonna do is add one more in there. Just when you think it's gonna all come out, I always feel like I can add one more and squish it down as I'm sewing it closed. Oh, in fact, I can see that needs a little more right there too. Stuff that down in there. Yeah, a little more, just for good measure. Okay, yep, that looks good. I'll put this aside. Now I'm gonna grab a sewing needle. Here. And, oh, actually, I think I have one right here. and a little bit of thread. Let's see. You want something that's kind of gonna coordinate with your fabric. Okay, that looks good. And if you don't know how to thread a hand sewing needle, I've got a great video that shows you how to do that. Okay, so I actually already threaded one here for me with a little knot at the end. And then you'll have to figure out how it feels comfortable for you to hold. I'm gonna start, like kind of hold it like that. And remember those two parts that we pressed under with our iron? Now that's gonna make it a little bit easier to see where I need to pull this over. So I'm gonna start with my needle down inside the fabric right here. There we go. So that knot is hidden inside. Then I'm just gonna use my strength, my super human sewing strength, to pull that little section closed. And there you go. I just kind of put that down, go through so that I'm kind of catching this little loop right here. And so it leaves a stitch on top. You can see how I did that. It makes like a little line and a stitch. Okay, I'm gonna do that again. Going over through that. And then just keep going down, pushing the stuffing back in the stuffing. You can use any kind of stitch that you like for hand sewing. If you like to do a slip stitch, a blanket stitch, a whip stitch, if you don't know what stitch, just do something that, you know, kind of uniformly keeps it closed. Okay, then at the end, you want to just do a couple little knots to hold it in place. And you will see the stitching on the outside of the pillow, but it's minimal, and you always want to try to find a spot where it's the most inconspicuous on your pillow. So I feel like this is a pretty good spot. Okay, cut that off. And I mean, we got a little cactus guy right there, but let's dress him up a little bit. Let's add some little spines. To create the spines on our cactus, we're gonna use yarn, and you can use all different types of yarn. You could use crochet thread. You could even use embroidery floss. It's fun in a variety of colors, and this one's kind of cool. It's got this natural looking vibe with the little speckles in it. So, you know, have fun finding the color you want to go with your cactus. This is kind of a cool concept of doing this monochromatic thing where it's yellow on yellow. That's kind of neat looking. And you can make the spines more sparse like I did here. Or if you look at what I was going for with this, a real saguaro has kind of these lines where the spines are, you can see sometimes. So that's kind of what I did here. You can do it however you want your cactus to look. So for this one, we're gonna use this creamy colored yarn right here. I'll set this aside. And you wanna find a needle that has a large enough eye to get your yarn through. So you can find tapestry needles that are large but might be blunt. I prefer to find one that has a little bit of a sharp edge to it. Okay, and then what is gonna save your sanity are these great little yarn threader things, whatever they're called. They go right inside the eye like that. Awesome, and then they give you a bigger hole to put your yarn in. Fantastic. Just like that. Pull it through, and then you can pull it right through like that. And they sell some other ones like this that have just like some wire on it. Those things always break. So these little metal ones that I found are really awesome. Okay, then pull it all the way down so that you have two yarns coming out of your needle. And the question is how long to make it? Well, if you make it really super long, then it's like pulling it through. But if you make it super short, which is easy, then you're rethreading it constantly. So just find your happy medium, what works for you. Okay, I'm gonna do it like that. And you don't even have to tie a knot in the end. That is a nice thing too. Okay, then if we're going to do a line, well, just decide what you wanna do. You can make it super random or the lines. I'm gonna start at the bottom here. And I found also that if you go through the fabric this way or if you go through the fabric vertically, it kind of depends which way your spine is gonna turn when you tie it in a knot. So play with that and figure that out for yourself as well. I'm gonna go in right here. I'm just making a small little hole, pulling it through till I get to the end here. And then I'm gonna tie this in a knot. And you can tie one knot or you can tie two knots. It doesn't matter. This is kind of like those quilts that some people like to make where you tie yarns instead of doing quilting on top. Just like that. Okay, then we're not gonna cut our thread yet. We're gonna continue sewing these little things all the way down and then cut at the end. So I'm gonna go down to the next one, spacing however you want. And I'm gonna try doing this one. Well, let's go like this. Let's go vertically and we'll see if it looks different. Okay, then all I have to do is I just need to go kind of like a little loop-de-loop around. That creates the knot itself. Pull like that, then move down to your next one. And if you find that it's hard to pull your needle through, you might also want to get a little thimble. I'm not sure if I have one here, and it kind of helps to pull that out so that you're not getting your skin kind of raw from pulling that. And how much space should you leave between these? Well, you want to leave enough that you can cut it without it being too short, and you might not know how short you want it. So I would give yourself a little bit of space until you try a few and then go from there. Okay, my little loop, come through, tie my knot. Let's go to the next one. There we go, a little loop. And pull it through. So another one, and then we'll cut it and you can see what it looks like. And again, this is just a really relaxing thing to do. I enjoy projects like that. Really fun to take in the car or even next road trip. I'm gonna make it a bunch of cacti. Okay, so there you go. We've got a bunch of those. I would have gone to the end of my yarn all the way up, but I'm gonna cut this here so you can see. And then when I was doing this guy, I didn't cut anything until the very end. It was so fun. It was like this maze of loops and stuff. So then you're gonna cut it right in the middle like this. Yay. Cut, cut. And then you can see, you can leave them long like that if that's the look you like, or you might want to trim it down a little bit and make really short spines. I kind of think that shorter looks maybe a little more realistic. Okay, there you go, sad little cactus guy. He lost most of his spines. But you'd want to finish and keep going. Okay, so do the rest of your spines and then let's add the finishing touch. Here's how I'm gonna make a cute little flower. There's lots of different ways to do this, but this is just one way that's worked for me. I like to use knit fabric scraps, and you can make this out of woven fabrics as well, but you know, when my kids grow out of their t-shirts, I just cut them up and use them for different little projects. So I have this really pretty corally orange and also this gold, which are great colors to go on your cactus. And I'm gonna cut a strip of fabric about 20 by 2 inches. Doesn't have to be those exact dimensions, just whatever you want. And that's what I made for this smaller flower here. If you want a larger flower like this yellow one, cut it even bigger. Okay. Strip like that. There you go. Then I went to my sewing machine and gathered it up, which if you're not sure how to gather, I've got a video about that as well. And then, let me set these aside. The nice thing about having these long little threads on the end is it's going to help us. I'm just going to take the fabric and start to kind of roll it around and I guess kind of gather it as I go. It's kind of like we're making a carnation flower in a way, if you can picture what that looks like also. And just doing this sort of action. No right or wrong here. Okay, looks pretty cute. And then, like I said, you end up with all these threads here that you would use for gathering. Those are the perfect thing to now just wrap around the end here to kind of seal it off, like so. Okay. And you know, with knit fabrics, they typically, the edges of them roll either out or under. I like to make sure that the way it's rolling out is going toward the outside of my flower because that kind of makes it stick out like petals. Okay, now let's cut a circle of our felt, the same felt that I used for, not felt, I'm sorry, flannel, the same fabric. And this is going to be the end of our flowers to seal off that raw edge. I'm just eyeballing this here. we go. And then this is going to go right around here and just kind of, you know, be the end of our flower like that. So grab my hot glue gun here. You can sew it too, but I'm just gonna hot glue it. So I'll just place a few little spots here. And always be careful when working with hot glue. If you're a child making this, please make sure that your parent is helping you. Because never fail, I burn myself every time I'm using one. Okay, I just press it down on the four sides like this. Well, four sides, but press it down kind of like a little square. And then you can add a little bit of glue into these in-between spots and kind of finagle it. And sometimes it helps to have pen or something else to burn instead of your finger. Let's do a little bit more right here. Push that in. Okay, that's pretty good. Okay, awesome. Okay, so look, there's our little flower. That's pretty cute. Ah, it's still hot. Okay, then what we would do is to find a spot on your cactus where you want this to go. It could look cute on the top. It looks super cute in the little crack of the arm right here. You could put two of them by each other, whatever you want to do. So let's say that we were going to put this guy right here. Grab a needle and thread, preferably the same color of your fabric. And then, you know, just, I don't know, do your work. Do your magic, you're sewing magic. Might be a little hard because of the glue that's in there, so just find spots where it can go through easily. And sew it on. And there you go, cute little cactus guy. For more ideas and tutorials, you can visit my website, madeeveryday.com. And for all of your sewing machine needs, head to babylock.com, where it's all for the love of sewing. Enjoy your cactus. Or two, or three, or four.